So today we are going to start with the time and place of supply under GST. Now, as we all know very well that GST is a destination-based tax. Destination-based tax means where the goods or the services which are being supplied by the supplier, that then we need to first specify or assess that what is the time of the supply, what is the place of the supply. Place plays a very important role here because we know that the GST framework is based upon the determination of tax depending upon the location where the goods or the services have been supplied. So when the goods are being moving or the services are being provided, then it is necessary to assess that what exactly is the place of supply where the recipient is receiving the goods. Because it might be possible that the recipient is somewhere else, the goods are being delivered to some other place, or the goods are being delivered to any other person other than the person who has ordered the goods or other than the person who has received the goods. So there might be certain situations where the place of supply needs to be verified, needs to be assessed differently. And without assessing that what is the place of supply, GST cannot be calculated. So since being a destination-based tax, it is essential part of GST computation that place of supply should be efficiently assessed. Now, when we talk about the place of supply here, place of supply means that where the goods are being provided, or fixing the destination of the goods. Now, that destination may differ in different circumstances or different situations. So that we are going to assess in this topic, that how the place of supply will be determined. Now, as you can see here, that written, there are two important components which determine the tax to be charged on a supply. One, location of the supplier, and other is the place of supply. Location of the supplier means it is the in general term, in literal meaning, we under GST we talk about the location of the supplier as the place of the business of the registered supplier. So any of the person who is paying tax under GST, it must be registered under registered place for business. So that will be the address that will be considered for the correspondence or communication. So any registered person who has who needs to get itself registered under GST, they need to provide a place of business, and that place of business will be considered as his recognized place for the location purpose. So when the supplier is supplying goods or the services, his registered place of business will be considered as the basis of determination of his address or the correspondence address or the location. Then next it is place of supply. Place of supply is in general term, if we talk about, it is the registered place of business of the recipient. So if nothing else has been provided, then the place of supply will be considered as the registered place of business of the recipient. So the recipient who is receiving the goods, the person who is receiving the goods, the registered place of that person, registered place of business of that person will be considered as the place of supply, right? Now, coming to the location of the supplier. First, we'll talk about the location of the supplier. The geographical point where the supplier is situated, together with the goods under his control, ready to be supplied. So, supplier of the goods is, you can say the location of the supplier can be fixed up at the place where the supplier is situated, together with the goods under his control, which is ready to be supplied. Or in general terms, we can say the registered place of business for the supplier will be the location of the supplier. If anything else has not been provided, then next is saying supplier of services. For the supplier of services, you can see here the registered place of business. Obviously, the first location that you need to fix up in case of the location of the supplier for the services is the registered place of business. If it is not there, then any place other than the place of business which is registered. If the registered place of business is not there, then any other place than the place of business which is registered, any other address that has been given by the registered person other than the place of business, that will be considered as his location. Or if these two does not exist, then in absence of any such place, the usual place of residence of the supplier. The usual place of residence of the supplier means if there is no registered place of business, if there is no other place of business that has been registered under the GST, then in absence of first and the second point, third is the usual place of residence of the supplier. If official address is not given, then it will be the residence which will be considered as the location of the supplier in case of services. So in case of goods when we are talking about, it is the registered place of business or the geographical point where the goods are under the control of the supplier. Second is, in the case of supplier of services, first will be the registered place of business. See, when we are talking about goods or the services, in both the cases, the first location will be first, preference will be given to the registered place of business. If it is not there, then in the case of services, any other place and the place of business which is registered. Any other address which is registered by the registered person. Then third is, if first and the second point is not there, then any other place which have been considered as the usual place of residence of the supplier. This is about the supplier. Then coming to types of supplies. Types of supplies here means that any type of supply which is getting to the GST or on which you need to do the GST compliance. Right. So now these supplies can be bifurcated under the heads given here. First is geographical basis. Geographical basis means on the basis of geographical locations, when you differentiate the type of supply, it can be the domestic supply or it can be the cross-border supplies. Now, domestic supplies here means when the goods are moving within the boundaries of the country. And cross-border supplies, you know very well, it is the when the goods are moving beyond the boundaries of the country. So domestic supply here means that your goods are not leaving the country boundaries. So now the geographical, on the basis of geographical location, it can be the domestic supplies which is within the boundaries of the country or the cross-border supplies which is beyond the boundaries of the country. Then next it comes the purpose of recipient. Purpose of recipient here means that what is the purpose for which the goods has been supplied. Under this, the supplies has been bifurcated under two heads. One is B2B supply and the other is B2C supply. B2B supplies here means business to business supplies. Business to business supplies means that one businessman is providing the goods to the other businessman for his business purpose, for his furtherance of business or for his course of business or doing the work which is related to the business. That is the B2B supplies. Then B2C supplies here means, you all must be knowing this because you have studied that in the marketing. B2C supply means that the supplies which are done by the business to the customer, to the consumer. So the when the B2C supplies are being made, the difference between here is that B2B supplies is basically done when one business is giving supplies to the other business, and the recipient here can use these supplies as the input supplies, and for that input supplies, that person is eligible to take the ITC benefit. Right. So when B2B supplies are there is opportunity for the businessman to consider this supply as the inward supplies, as the input supplies, and for which the businessman or the registered person can take the ITC. But when we talk about the B2C supply, B2C supply is the supplies where the business is supplying to the consumer, and in that case the ITC is not available because we are supplying to the consumer and consumer is not further selling it as the outward supply. So there is no question of ITC under B2C supply. So when we talk about this B2B supplies, the basic concept here is that it refers to the business to business supply. Here two businesses are involved, two businessmen are involved, two registered persons are involved who are conducting their businesses, and for the purpose of their business they are having the supplies. Then the recipient is acting in the course of or in the furtherance of his business. Whatever the goods are being received by the business, that is related to the business, and most probably it is in the course of or in the furtherance of his business it is received, and the recipient can claim the ITC for this if this has been used as an input supplies, which is further used for the outward supplies by the business. The next is the B2C supply, which we were discussing. Now when we talk about B2C supply, it is business to consumer supply. The two parties are the business and the consumers here, and the recipient is the end user, you can say. So that is why we are calling it as the consumer. And there is no question of ITC here because this supply affecting B2C supply is not further creating any outward supply in this situation. So no input tax credit will be available for such supplies. Now suppose if we take an example here, let's take up a event management company, and event management company is hiring the services of a caterer. So in this case, if an event management company is hiring the services of a caterer, it is a B2B supply. So in that case, the ITC benefit is available because event management company is there and the caterer. Event management company is taking the services of the caterer as an input services. And so your ITC is effective. Now suppose if B2C supply is there, B2C supply means, let's say if I have my personal function at home, and I being the registered person, I am a businessman, I have a business of ready-made garments, right? And I have my family function, and in that family function I have taken the catering services of that same caterer, right? So now this will become B2C supply, means the caterer is supplying his services to the businessman, but for the personal reason, for the personal purpose. So this will not be the B2B supply, it will be B2C supply, and therefore the same supply